Hey there, I'm Mike, and today we're going to explore pseudocode and how it can improve your programming. Pseudocode is a way of representing code using a combination of simple, natural language and elements of programming language, whether you're just starting out in the world of programming or you're a seasoned pro. Understanding pseudocode is a time-saving trick you can integrate into your process at any time. In this video, we'll dive into what pseudocode is, how it's used, and why it's an essential tool for any developer. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is pseudocode? It's called pseudocode because it's not actually executable. Instead, it's a way for humans to understand and plan out the logic in coding to describe the steps of a program in a way that's easy for humans to understand while still being detailed enough to be rapidly converted into a specific programming language. Here's a simple example of pseudocode in which we're working out the basic logic to greet a visitor by name when they navigate to our site or app. As you can see, the pseudocode isn't written with syntax from any actual language or framework. Instead, it uses simple, universally understandable language and programming elements to stand in as syntax, making it simple for anyone to follow. The main benefits pseudocode can bring to developers, both novice and experienced, are improved efficiency. By writing out the steps of a process in pseudocode, developers can save time by planning out their code before diving into the details or syntax of a specific programming language. This can help coders avoid mistakes and reduce the need for debugging. It's easier to read. Since pseudocode is written to be simple enough for anyone to understand, it makes it easier for developers to read and understand code, especially if they're working with a team or need to revisit old code. Greater flexibility. Because pseudocode isn't tied to any specific programming language, it can be easily adapted to different languages. This makes it a useful tool for developers who are familiar with multiple languages and need to translate their ideas between different languages. Enhanced collaboration. Pseudocode can be used as a common language for a team of developers to communicate and collaborate on a project. This can be especially useful for teams working on a project together, as pseudocode allows developers to clearly and concisely communicate their ideas. Local management. Because it's not executable, your pseudocode won't need to be hosted online or connected to any external scripts like a full-fledged app would. It can be created and saved in a file on your local machine, in a cloud file, or even copied into an email. In addition, writing pseudocode is easy to implement at any stage of your development process. Because of pseudocode's inherent flexibility, there are plenty of uses for pseudocode, even outside the realm of programming. Here are several common use cases for developers. Planning and designing processes. Communicating ideas to non-technical stakeholders. Collaborating with a team. Adapting code to different programming languages, and teaching programming concepts. Now, these are just a few examples, and many more exist. The possibilities for implementing pseudocode to your advantage are virtually limitless. There's no one right way to write pseudocode. The same lack of specific syntax that makes it so flexible is exactly what precludes it from having any particular syntax rules. While some languages like Pascal and Basic offer syntax-specific pseudocode guidelines, you can actually write pseudocode using any terminology you like, so long as your terms are ubiquitous and the logic is followable. That said, there are some basic steps and guidelines for pseudocode that most developers adhere to. Here are some general steps you can follow to write good pseudocode. Open your text editor. Pseudocode is most often written in text or HTML editor. You can pick your favorite and open a new file. Define your goal. Determine the purpose of your program or function. What do you want it to do? Separate it into parts. Break down the problem into smaller, more manageable chunks. This can help you think about the problem more clearly and make it easier to arrange the pieces so they work where and when they should. Organize it into steps. Write out the steps on your program in logical order. Use natural language and avoid using specific programming constructs or methods such as control structures or typecasting. Indent your lines. Use indentation to show the structure of your program. For example, you might indent the lines of code that belong inside a loop. Test it. Test your pseudocode to make sure it's clear and logical. You can do this by walking through it verbally or having someone else read it and report back to you what they think the pseudocode is supposed to do. Once your pseudocode is written, you'll need to translate it into an executable script. You can practice this outside your projects by contributing to open source Git repositories, taking on code challenges, and asking or answering questions on Stack Overflow or within your development community. Despite pseudocode's lack of a defined syntax, there are several common programming constructs that developers often utilize when writing pseudocode. Let's take a look at each. A sequence is a group of statements that are executed in a specific order. They're used to perform or repeat a series of simple actions. Some familiar sequence commands commonly used in pseudocode include input, set, print, read, display, show, and calculate. Here's an example of pseudocode that uses some of these commands. This pseudocode defines a process called calculate cost that takes in a price and quantity, multiplies them together to calculate the cost, and then displays the result. Conditional statements allow a program to make decisions based on certain conditions, then direct the program to execute certain statements if a condition is met or not met. If else, if, else else, and case statements are frequently utilized in pseudocode. Here's an example showing an if-else script in pseudocode. In this example, we're describing a process that shows a welcome back message to users who have visited before, but shows only welcome to new users. Iteration statements repeat a set of steps within a larger function or process. They're often tasked to perform the same operation on multiple items in a list or to repeat a process until certain conditions are met. Iterations are useful for repeating a set of steps multiple times and can be implemented using various types of loops, including for, while, and do while loops. Let's look at some pseudocode that uses a for loop to iterate through a list of numbers. In this pseudocode, our print whole list process takes in a list of numbers and then iterates through the list, displaying for each number on the screen. The for loop allows the process to repeat the print command for each item in the list. Alternatively, we could utilize the common pseudocode to accomplish the same as in our loop example. In pseudocode, it's more common to use the keywords repeat and until in place of do while. As shown here, we can switch out the names, keywords, and syntax pieces all we like. This is just one demonstration of pseudocode's flexibility. The key is to ensure that the logic is stable while using names that are ubiquitous enough to be read by anyone. As we mentioned earlier, there is no strict syntax for writing pseudocode, since it's not an actual programming language. That said, here are a few general guidelines that can help you write clear, effective pseudocode each time. Use natural language. Pseudocode should be written in a way that's easy for anyone to understand using natural language rather than technical jargon. Keep it simple. Avoid using complex language or syntax and focus on expressing the steps of the algorithm or process in a clear and concise way. Be specific. Be as specific as possible when writing pseudocode, including information such as variable names and specific values. Leave out unnecessary details. If you're worrying about which case convention to adopt or whether to use semicolons, you're overthinking it. Make your pseudocode text as simple and straightforward as possible. Use programming-like elements. While pseudocode should not be written in a specific programming language, it can be helpful to use elements such as loops, conditional statements, and function calls to make it easier for readers to understand your program's steps. Use indentation to show hierarchy. Indentation can be used to show the hierarchy of the steps in your program, making it easier to understand the logic and structure. By following these guidelines, you can write clear and effective pseudocode that you and others can use as a guide for implementing your function or algorithm in a specific programming or scripting language. Here at Kinsta, we take hosting and performance to the next level. With our application hosting, you can run almost any app in a matter of minutes with full support for all your favorite languages and frameworks. And our database hosting allows for easy database creation with full control over every aspect of your project. Explore these features and more at kinsta.com/application-hosting. Thank you so much for watching. And if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.